to the scene and I pat him down to check if he had a weapon, and he refused and hit me. So I shot him without even thinking. Do I regret killing him? Maybe, but it was self-defense. I was threatened. But then it all got out of hand. Once they found out who I was, they started attacking me. Physically, verbally, and through the internet. And was it really my fault? Did I deserve this?
He was my friend. What did you expect me to do? We started off with peaceful protests, and then other people got involved, and it turned to violence. They started throwing things and smashing shop windows, and they turned against each other.
I watched my brother get shot. How do you think I was going to react?
I don't think anyone meant it to get violent.
It just happened.
And it was the only way we could get them to...
Listen!
I was home alone, and it was really late, and then all of a sudden I smelled this really thick smoke coming up the stairs, and I looked out the window, and there was so many flames, and the firemen were telling me, jump, jump, come on! But I couldn't, and then I fell.
This is Lauren Thomas, reporting from Central London. A 20-year-old woman had to jump from her 8-storey apartment today due to a fire that was presumably started by London riots. She's recovering now in hospital. During the London riots, there were 5 deaths and 16 injured.
3,000 arrests. 1,000 people issued with criminal charges.
3,443 crimes.
All because one man shot one victim.
Could the outcome have been different if we were all treated equally?